Time Magazine, partnering with Verizon, just released its Innovative Teachers 2022 list. 10 educators making a difference for their students in a unique way. And the list includes Dr. Fatima Morrell, the Buffalo School District's Associate Superintendent for Culturally and Linguistically Responsive Initiatives. We've spoken to her before about her goal to include an anti-racist curriculum in Buffalo schools and make sure that students are learning different and diverse perspectives on their history. And Dr. Morrell joins us now live to talk about the honor and her work that's going on right here in Western New York. First of all, congratulations. This is quite an honor, 10 across the country. Tell us what the recognition means to you, especially because as we've covered here, you've faced a lot of opposition in the past with what you're trying to do and the type of curriculum that you're trying to bring to students.
Yes, it does feel like a great reward for a lot of hard work against a lot of odds and criticism and misunderstandings as well. So it does feel tremendous in that our work, our teachers, our district community, our city is being recognized on a national level for anti-racist work as well as culturally responsive practices district-wide. In Buffalo, and so we're very proud. I'm very proud of that and honored that Time would consider honoring me in this way. Very humbled.
Yeah, absolutely. And of course, you acknowledge so many people that you work with. It's very humble of you as well. Buffalo has been ground zero, as you know, for this discussion now that's happening about white supremacy after the racist massacre that happened at the Tops Market here last month. In fact, there was another hearing on Capitol Hill today before a Senate committee looking specifically at white supremacy because of the attack that happened here in Buffalo. How has that changed your work?
Absolutely. We immediately in the Buffalo Public Schools went into full healing mode because we realized that we had been traumatized by the massacres and the actions that dismantled how we feel about safety as Black people in Buffalo. And so we went into full healing mode, and we began with putting out work for teachers and administrators around healing practices and social emotional learning and wellness lessons. Additionally, we put into place a compendium of lessons and resources related to racism, white supremacy, and how racism actually leads to white supremacy and how dangerous that truly is when we don't disrupt or dismantle ideologies that places that devalues people of color, Black people particularly, and it instills hatred in a way that, as we saw here in Buffalo, became very dangerous and really, you know, hurt our community in a very deep way that we now must dig ourselves out from under the weight of this white supremacist action. And so it changed our, you know, once again, our work is now pivoting towards looking at the legacy of white supremacy, which actually also has roots in the institution of slavery, and how that those atrocities that were perpetuated upon people of color because of their skin color, you know, so long ago, beginning in 1619 and all the way through today, and tying and showing the linkages between the thought processes that went into someone actually feeling like they could dehumanize a group of people based upon the color of their skin, and making that connection back to the whole system of enslavement for profit and the atrocities committed upon my people because of their skin color. So we want our young people to know that racism is real and that white supremacy is also very real, and that it also is not as overt as we saw with the massacres that came here. It's also beneath the surface in how Black people are treated in our city many times and in various institutions. And, you know, and that goes along with the historic, Buffalo's history of redlining and economic disparities and educational disparities and so forth. Transportation disparities, Just so many. And so that's where we are with explaining to our young people that this also has legacy in enslavement, but we don't approach it with hatred. We approach it with understanding and loving our neighbors.
I wish that we had even more time to talk about this. We are out of time, unfortunately, but congratulations once again. We've been talking with Associate Superintendent Dr. Fatima Morrell. Congratulations and thanks for coming on.
Thank you so much. Have a good day.
All right, you do the same.